Let us study about de-excitation of an excited atom. We already studied that one electromagnetic radiation photon is supplied to an atom. If the photon energy is equal to the difference in two energy levels of the atom, the electron in lower energy state will excite to the higher energy state. Say initially the electron was in N1 state and after supply of this photon it will excite to N2 state. If the photon energy is equal to the difference of the two energy levels En2 minus En1, then it will excite. But as we know that higher states in an atom are states with higher amount of energy of electron. So lower states are always more stable compared to the higher energy levels. In this situation we can say, after some time, generally the time is of the order of 10 to power minus 8 seconds, this is maximum. After which one electron is trying to be stable in the higher energy level. After this time it will realize, or we can state as lower energy levels in between N2 and N1 as well as N1 are available as vacant states. Then certainly electron will make a reverse transition from higher level to the lower level. So it has many possibilities. It can either shift to any of the intermediate states or directly back to the state N1 and will release different photon or photons in the process. And finally it will come back to the lowest vacant energy state, because always we can say lower energy levels are more stable compared to higher energy levels. So in this situation we can say, when an electron is excited to any higher level, in that level it will stay there for a maximum of 10 to power minus 8 second, which is also called lifetime of excited state, or it is also termed as lifetime of excitation, after which it will have a tendency to transit back to the lower energy state wherever vacancies are there. If there are more states which are vacant, then based on probability it can transit to any of the lower state which are available vacant randomly. Now in this process, which we call de-excitation of an atom, electron emits electromagnetic radiation photon which is equal to the energy difference of the two corresponding energy levels. This is the phenomena we call de-excitation. Let's have a look with a realistic situation also. Here you can see this is the energy band diagram for a hydrogen atom, in which we are seeing here the four energy levels 1, 2, 3 and 4 corresponding energies are also written here. We know that energy difference of 1 and 4 state is 12.75 electron volt. So if an external photon of 12.75 electron volt incident onto this electron in n equals to 1 state, it will transit directly to n equals to 4. And after a time of approximately 10 to power minus 8 seconds, it will have a tendency to transit back to any of the lower state. And here you can see there are three vacant state. It can transit to any of the three state, either to 3 or to 2 or to 1. And in the three transitions, it can release the photons of energy which are equal to energy difference of 4 to 3, which is 0.66 electron volt. Energy difference of 4 to 2, which is of 2.55 electron volt, and energy difference of 4 to 1, that is 12.75 electron volt. Either of these three transition will take place, and here we can see if it transit to 4 to 3, then a photon of 0.66 will be emitted, and again from 3 it can transit to 2 or 1, and respectively it can emit further photons. But ultimately we can see as n equals to 1 is vacant, which is the most stable state. Here we can see finally it will be coming back to n equals to 1, and any number of photons it can emit in between transitions, and finally it will drop back to n equals to 1 state.